Hey guys, my name is Scubby. Today I'm going to be showing you how to play PS3 games on your PC. For this, we're going to be using the emulator RPCS3. On screen right now, you can see me playing some Dragon's Crown. Let's jump right into this. The first thing I want to do is download the emulator itself. Links are always under the description down below. Just download whatever the latest version is. In this case, it's version 0.0.2 alpha. Just click the latest builds available. Click here. You'll be brought over to the AppVayer page. Click the link here and your download will begin for whatever the latest version of your emulator is. You might have a slightly different version, but download whatever the latest version is. It should be the most stable version available at the time. We're also going to be downloading the actual PlayStation firmware, which we're going to need to come to this PlayStation link. Links are always down below. And we're going to be downloading the latest version right here. This is the Russian page, but it does not make a difference. It's all the same and it will work just as well. Get both of these files downloaded and move them to a location where you can find them easily. While I'm in the browser, I'm also going to bring you to the compatibility page, and this is going to be a list of all PlayStation 3 games that are compatible, and it's going to break them down into categories of how compatible they are with this emulator currently. Of course, they're updating this as they can. With every latest build, they're going to try fix and add more games. This is the official RPCS3 website. You can support their Patreon if you want to help them out, or if you want just some more information about the emulator, about the blog, you can read it all over on here. I'd recommend checking this out also. You can check out the full list of games here to see what's playable, to see what's not, and I'd recommend checking this out. So once your files are downloaded and you've checked out the compatibility list, we're going to start installing and setting up our games. So what you want to do is make a new folder named RPCS3, and we're going to be extracting our emulator files into this. We're going to be opening up the emulator that is zipped, and we're going to be extracting all the files across to our blank folder with WinRAR 7-zip. Once all our files are across, we're going to be installing the firmware that I also have downloaded here. So what we're going to want to do is open up the RPCS3 actual application, click run, and your emulator will open up for the first time. We're going to click OK, I have read this, and click OK. If you want this message to never pop up again, just click do not show again. I'm going to click OK, and we're going to start doing some stuff to get this emulator up and running. So the first thing I'm going to be doing is clicking the boot on the top left, and we're going to be installing the firmware, and then we're going to be locating to the file that we just downloaded from the PlayStation website. In this case, it's the ps3up.pup. We're going to click OK, and the firmware is going to start installing. We're going to need this to actually get our games to run, and we're going to be doing one more thing with this file once we're ready. Now that the file is installed, it'll give you this success message. Click OK, and then we're going to decrypt the files that we have just installed in this firmware. We're going to be doing this by going to utilities, and we're going to be looking for SPRX decryption. Now, depending on the version of the emulator you're using, these messages might be in slightly different locations, but look for some variants of the functions I'm showing and you should get on just fine. We're going to go back to utilities. We're going to go to SPRX decryption. We're going to be locating to our actual RPCS3 folder, the installation path. We're going to be going to the dev flash folder. We're going to be going to the system folder. We're going to be going to external, and then we're going to be selecting all of the files in this folder. So you can either click Control and A, or you can drag and highlight all the files. Click open, and it's going to start decrypting all of the firmware files, which is going to let our games actually play and install. So now we have our emulator ready, we're ready to start installing and getting our games up and ready. I'm not going to be showing you in today's video where to download games, but I should also mention there's two different types of games. There's games that can be downloaded from the PSN store that require .wrap files for verification in this emulator, and there's just games that run directly off a disk or .iso files that do not require any .wrap files for verification. There's some software out there that will let you download PSN games directly along with the .wrap files really easily. I can't show you what that software is, but it's really easy to find. Some Google searching will help you out. And games are pretty easy to find if you know where to look. Quick Google searches will help you out with all of these. But like I said, I'm going to be showing you how to set up and install the games as well. So what we're going to do is come up to boot on the top left. We're going to be going to install PKG, and this is going to be to install PSN downloaded games. You want to locate to where your games are downloaded. So mine are on my D drive. They're in PSN stuff. They're in downloads, and I'm going to be installing dragonscrown.pkg. Simply click open and your game will actually install as if it was an actual PS3. So it is going to bring it over to the actual installation path, and I'll be showing you where that is in 1 second if you want to just drag and drop your games over. But I should note that they need to be in a specific file format and version, and I'll show you how that looks also. If you get a PKG file, all you need to do is install it and the emulator will take care of the rest. Once it's installed, it'll have this little pop-up message. We can click OK. So now that we have our game installed, if we try to open it up, we can tell that we're missing the .wrap file for this actual game, and we can really easily fix this, like I'll show you in 1 second. Now, while I'm here, I'm also going to show you that this is our log, or this is like a console, and this is going to give information about the game. So if there's any loading issues or any difficulties, you could bring these issues over to Google or post them in the forum, and people can give you specific help according to your problem. So use the log effectively. If you're having issues, post down in the comments. I'll try to help, or look on Google and see if anyone else has your issue and has helped to fix it. Now we're ready to get our wrap file sent over. I'm going to be showing you some of the settings, and now we're going to be getting the game up and running. So I have my wrap file over here. In this case, we're going to be looking at the Dragon's Crown wrap file. We're going to be bringing it over to our actual RPC S3 emulator. We're going to bring it over onto the dev underscore HDD0. We're going to be going to home. We're going to be going to 0001. We're going to be going to xdata, and we're going to be bringing our wrap files into this folder. From here, we're going to be going back over to our emulator. We're going to be closing it down. We're going to be reopening it back up, and our game should be able to run. If you open back up our PCS3, click run. Our little pop-up message will come up one more time, and Dragon's Crown should start running from the beginning. Simply double-click, or you can right-click and click launch, and your game will start to run. And as you can tell, it's as simple as that to get PS3 games up and running. I'm going to be showing you some of the settings now. I'm going to close this down. We'll come back to it in a second. So real quick, I just wanted to show you how the games actually look when they're installed. So if we open up our actual RPC S3 folder, if we head into dev underscore HDD0, and if we head to game instead of home, we can see all the games we have currently installed. So the test 12345 is a default one that's just on the actual emulator. We don't need to worry about that. But here is the Dragon's Crown actual folder. If we open it up, this is what the games will actually look like. And if your game is in this kind of format, you can drag the file directly over. And this is what the actual installation process does. Puts it onto the PlayStation emulator as if it was an actual game. And then we link back to the wrap file, which then works as if it was an actual game on the actual PlayStation. So if we come up to our config, we can go to settings, and here we have some of our core settings that we need to set up. So you basically want to copy all of the settings I have here. You want to set your PPU decoder to interpreter. You want to set the SPU decoder to recompiler, and you want to make sure your load libraries is automatically load required libraries, so your emulator will run as smooth as possible. So if you're having some difficulty with your game, or you feel like it's running bad or it's lagging a little bit, you can set your renderer from OpenGL to Vulkan, and then you can select your dedicated graphics card right here. If you're having some difficulties with Vulkan, go back to OpenGL, and I would recommend jumping back and forth for some games if you're having difficulties. This can be where most of your difficulties will lie, but it can also help you give you some more FPS if your game is running bad. You also have some other graphical settings right here. I would recommend leaving these alone for the most part. Most people's PCs, you'd need a pretty powerful PC to run anything above 720. For now, I'm going to leave it on OpenGL because I seem to have little difficulties with Dragon's Crown in this case. Audio, I would recommend leaving it at X Audio 2 because this is the best version for this actual emulator, although it can give some difficulties if you are run it over to OpenAL, and you can change that up here. We have our input and output here. You can set up a keyboard, a controller, whatever else you want to change. You can come in here and change all the settings. Last thing I would recommend would be changing your system language, whatever your language is here. For this, I'm going to be setting it to English US. Everything else I would recommend leaving alone. You can come in here and have a mess around with the settings if you wish. The main two you need to look at if you're having difficulties running a game are setting your renderer from OpenGL to Vulkan, or vice versa, and setting your audio from X Audio to OpenAL, and vice versa. Other than that, your emulator should run perfectly smooth. If we click OK, we can reopen our game, and our game will start to run. It's as simple as that to install games. If your game is running from a disk or a .iso image, like I said, you won't need a .wrap file and your game should work. Check out the compatibility list down below and you can see what works. I'm just going to play a little bit more Dragon's Crown here so you can see that everything works and I can move around. I am using my keyboard as an input right now because I don't have my controller connected in, but everything should work just perfectly fine. If you're having any difficulty with this, let me know in the comments down below. Like I said, all the information is down below. I'm going to leave my PayPal link down below if you want to support me and you found this emulator tutorial helpful. I have a bunch of other emulator tutorials over here on my channel if you want to check those out. I would really appreciate it if you would. Like I said, if you have any difficulties, let me know in the comments down below. I'm going to leave two videos on screen. The one on the left is going to be my most recent upload. And the one on the right is going to be one that YouTube most suggests that you will watch. So you should probably check it out because it's apparently for you. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, as always, keep it saucy. Peace.